I argue that the betas we measure, that is, those betas reported in financial websites, contain two sources of risk: business risk and financial risk. As you will see later, it will be convenient to be able to separate these two sources of risk. To do that, we will use the following equation. In this formula, beta sub E stands for beta equity. This is the beta that contains both the business risk and the financial risk. When we look up a beta in Yahoo or Google Finance, we get beta equity. It is also called lever beta because this is the beta that includes the effect of debt on the risk of equity. Beta sub A stands for beta assets. This beta measures only the business risk of a firm. It is called beta assets because it depends only on the risk of the free cash flows generated by the assets of the firm, and it does not depend on the amount of debt. This beta is also called unlevered beta, since it does not include the effect of leverage. The term ND over E is a measure of the amount of net debt in the firm relative to its equity. The formula tells you that the higher the level of net debt over equity, the higher the beta equity. This is precisely what we discussed in the numerical example from before. The higher the net debt, the higher the riskiness of equity. One comment before we move on. There are different formulas that relate beta equity and beta asset. Each of these formulas arises from different assumptions made about the capital structure. The specific formula I'm giving you is the one I believe has broader applicability. Explaining the different formulas is, however, beyond the scope of this course.